Have you ever looked at the Wikipedia page of a gas giant and thought, man, I wish I knew this much about my fictional gas plant? Why am I even asking? Of course you have, let's do this. YouTube, Edgar here, and welcome to Artifexian. Here you will learn everything you ever wanted to know about world building, and then some. The mass range of gas giants is 10 Earth masses to 13 Jupiter masses. Simple. Radius, however, is a little more nuanced. Between 2 and 13 Jupiter masses, a body will always be 1 Jupiter radius in size. Larger radii only occur below 2 Jupiter masses. This is kind of counterintuitive, and you can thank electron degeneracy for that. All these things considered, let's build. First up, let's construct a super Jupiter, i.e. a giant planet more massive than Jupiter. Again, we can use the planet maker equation from the last video. Gravity is equal to mass over the radius squared, which is equal to the radius times the density. Seeing as we are dealing with a super Jupiter, I'm going to pick, say, 3 Jupiter masses. Now, given that it's above the 2 Jupiter mass limit, it must have a radius of 1 Jupiter radii. But for the sake of avoiding mathematical mundanity, I'll allow myself to go plus or minus a few percent. Cause you know who likes boring maths? Nobody, that's who. 1.03 Jupiter radii should do the trick. Solving for gravity and density yields the following stats. Remember, all values here are relative to Jupiter being equal to 1. And to convert them to absolute values, just multiply them by Jupiter's absolute values. So, here's Jupiter, and here's Earth, and here, to scale, is our super Jupiter. Same radius, seriously more massive. And now for something completely different. Let's build a Puffy giant planet, i.e. a planet below 2 Jupiter masses, but with a radius larger than Jupiter. So I'll set my mass at, say, 0.48, and my radius at 1.9. Again, plug the values into the planet maker, solve for gravity and density, and you get the following results. Now, these figures may seem a bit crazy, but they are in fact the stats of the exoplanet WASP-17b, proof that real-life Puffy giants are truly bonkers in nature. I mean, if we multiply that density value by Jupiter's absolute density, we see that this world has a density of 0.09 grams per centimeter cubed. That's a whopping 7.5 times less dense than Saturn. And hey, if that doesn't initiate cranial mind blow, you should seriously consider running a level 1 diagnostic to see why you are not functioning within the established parameters. Digression aside, it's worth noting that the least dense exoplanet discovered to date has a density of 0.03 grams per centimeter cubed, and the planet with the largest radius is in fact WASP-17b at 1.9 Jupiter radii. Consider these a couple of figures to bear in mind when constructing your worlds. Again, here's Jupiter, and here's Earth, and here is our Puffy planet. Finally, let's build a gas dwarf, i.e. a gaseous planet that is smaller than Uranus or Neptune. These planets break all the above parameters as they are transitional worlds, blurring the lines between gas planet, ocean planet, and rocky planet. Conservatively speaking, a gas planet will be no smaller than about 2 Earth radii and could have a mass anywhere between 1 and 20 Earth masses. As explained in the previous video, this means that the gas dwarf will likely follow a generic mass-radius relationship, so we can use this graph to get realistic mass and radius values. Here's the 2 radius line, so everything below that is out. Below a mass of 1 and above a mass of 20 is also out. And seeing as our gas dwarf will obviously be composed of gas, everything here, gone. Links, by the way, in the doobly-doo. Okay, so let's go with, say, 2 Earth masses and 4 Earth radii. Plug the values into the planet maker, and huzzah, we get these stats. Bear in mind, we are now talking in terms of the Earth being equal to 1. And for the final time, we got Jupiter and Earth, and here, to scale, is our gas dwarf. So that's how you build the various types of giant planet. Remember, you can help flesh out your world by calculating escape velocity, surface area circumference, and volume, just as we did in the previous video. Finally, a warning. Not all types of gaseous planet can be placed wherever you want in your planetary system. In order of increasing distance from their host star, we are likely to find Puffy planets here, gas giants and super Jupiters here, and gas dwarfs here. But more on that when we discuss orbits in a later video. Guys, if you like what you see here in Artifexian, click the links in the description to find me on Facebook and Twitter. And if you're interested, hit like and subscribe for more awesome science-based world building. Thank you all so much for watching. Edgar out.